three people. We're going to, they're all LIGO members. They are the LIGO group at Columbia University in New York. We're delighted to have them here. Two of them got their PhDs from here. We're quite proud of them and by association us, I guess. So, first and last speaker, the Alpha and Omega of the triumvirate, will be the man in the white shirt. I've worn my white shirt today out of respect for him. His name is Zavi Marka. He was a student here with Steve Chorna. He worked on a Clio experiment at the time, which is E plus E minus glider to Cornell. Then he got his PhD. He took a bus dive with Barry Barish at Caltech. I think he was stationed mostly in Livingston. Is that so?
I hope, but not. I was traveling 70% of my time, so I was leaning in a hotel and driving rental cars.
Okay.
Between Hanford and Washington, Hanford, Washington, and Livingston, Louisiana, and Caltech, while doing it.
So I guess he was not the driver. I guess he was the worker for that aspect of LIGO. And his wife, Zsuzsa Marka, she also got a Caltech PhD, Caltech postdoc after she got her PhD here in Kinnis Bano Dorm Tulk. And she spent some time at Caltech and then at UCLA, and then she went to Columbia as a Zavi. And then our third person, whom I just met today, is Imre Bartos. His background is, he's Hungarian as well. His background is his education is Hungarian. As Zavi says, he's younger than the others. He doesn't know what communism is like as a discovering event. And he doesn't know what waltz are like. So he's had a good life. He went directly from Hungary to Colombia, where he's been for 10 years as just an instructor. So without further ado, I'll let the Alpha Man begin this. That would be Zavi Marka.
Thank you very much. It is always a pleasure to be here. Last time I was here 3 years ago, and I could only promise you that we will discover gravitational waves. And today we are very happy to tell you that indeed our promise is fulfilled and we discovered gravitational waves. For some, the quest is going on for 100 years. Einstein predicted gravitational waves really exactly 300 years ago in 1916, and some of us only spent like 16 years chasing them, others spent a lifetime. My great friends like Ray and Kip spent 40 years, so it's a long quest. When I joined LIGO, everybody told me I'm crazy, I should continue doing particle physics because nobody will ever see these things, it's impossible, and so on. So I said, well, that's why I'm a scientist. Impossible is my business. So I kept up, and I'm very happy that I was not crazy. So, yes, we have them. And we did not discover directly gravitational waves only, but we also observed close, up close and personal, the first binary black hole system dying and the black hole being born. So it is multiple discoveries, matter of fact three, yeah? Discovering gravitational waves directly, discovering the binary black hole, and proving Einstein's theory in a regime that it was never proved before. Heavy black holes emerging, really cool. So, you know, I dreamed about it. I never thought it would be possible, but nature treated us to this wonderful first event, and that made the last weeks and the last month beautiful and horrible in the same time. Because then we had to keep the secret, and we had to work really hard, yeah? And no, it's a pleasure to tell you about this. So, I guess you read about it. This is the biggest science news. I was amazed. We got to the front page of New York Times and the quote of the day and so on. This means a lot, because this means science is getting to everybody. And that's very important, because we also do science to help people live better. So more people appreciate, better it is. And I just want to show you that We are here from the Columbia Group. We are a symbolism. LIGO is a collaboration, 900 people, 70 institutions on every continent, except Antarctica, say. So we are everywhere, and we are representing a huge group, and most importantly, our work was made possible by many, many talented students. So I will give the honor to the students who made our work possible. So I will go through many, many pictures we took during the years, showing you how many talented minds who became successful scientists all over the place helped us. So this is from 2006 to 2010. Many of these young minds are in LIGO, many of them are not. Many more helping us during the ways, and we are getting closer and closer to discovery. You see Alexa smiling, building part of advanced LIGO, and then on the next one, you see Alexa really happy. You know why? She is very happy, because exactly a year before the announcement on February 11, she switched on the LIGO Hanford Observatory, the most sensitive instrument ever built. And she was a student with us at Columbia. We were so happy. Yeah? So discovery was done. We discovered gravitational waves. Everybody asked us, oh, what did you feel? Well, I was asleep. Yeah. I think nature discriminates against the United States, because the event came to Earth when Europeans were up. So Europeans sent out an email that here is something, hopefully looking like a gravitational wave. Yeah. And then Zsuzsa gets up in the morning and sends Imre and me an email. Guys, you should look at this. This is interesting. You see that? So, Zsuzsa had the honor of seeing the discovery first time. Did I believe it? I didn't care. Yeah. I started to believe when my senior colleague David Shoemaker circulated the email that no, we did not have secret injections. We were not ready. The event came too early. Well, I was sure that, so nobody messed with the machine. Maybe it's real. And then, during the next weeks, we gained confidence, and we had to keep it secret because we wanted to have a rock-solid announcement, a rock-solid detection paper. Yeah. And here is the timeline, and what you really have to know is that we did find this event 3 minutes after it arrived to Earth. So it really happened when Earth had only single-cell organisms, and then it traveled in the cosmos for a billion years. It got here, LIGO recorded the data, and within 3 minutes, our great code found it. So this is pretty cool. So what happened in the cosmos far, far away? Here is a video which kind of illustrates what happens when two black holes are orbiting each other. You see that they orbit each other, and their gravity is bending the light from the stars behind them. That's why you have that distortion. And they get closer and closer to each other. They lose energy, radiating gravitational waves, and they speed up as it merged. And then quiet down, and it's over. It's a nice, quiet black hole. And then the signal travels for a billion years, and then it gets here. And what I forgot to do is plug in my this, because I want to show you some. I see that is it. Yes. Yeah, I want to show you the sound gravitational waves make in the LIGO Observatory. Because a gravitational wave observatory is nothing else but a microphone translating gravitational waves to light. Did you hear it? So I was cheating. Yeah? So the first, now you didn't hear it, this is the signal we had seen. The second, we shifted by 400 hertz, so we can hear it. Yeah? It's still the signal, but it was at higher pitch. So some artist already contacted us about C, the note C, music artist. So we have to tell them that how it happened at a very low 100 to 200 hertz region. It's still okay. Isn't that beautiful? You see this? You see this graph? X is time. We are really talking about half a second. The full thing played out in half a second. And you see that the frequency range was really 100 to 200 hertz. And you see that the signal was weaker in LIGO Livingston and stronger in LIGO Hanford. And you don't see the time delay, but there's a bit of time delay, and that's very important. And Zsuzsa will tell you why the time delay is important. We can actually simulate this. We can actually have a simulation about the black holes going around each other. And this turns out to be a very important part of the story, because these numerical simulations give us the waveform. What you see at the bottom with that blue worm coming up, yeah, and you see that at the beginning, very far from the merger on the right, the waveform is pretty periodic, but now it's speeding up, the frequency increases, yeah, the two black holes are getting close together, yeah, and then when we get close to the merger,